ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
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 नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयत्मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिके कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। Reading from chapter canto 11, chapter 13, verse number 18. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Evam Pushto Mahadeva Swayam Bhur Bhuta Bhavana Dhyaya Mana Prashna Bijam Nabhya Padyatta Karmadhi Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Evam Pushto Mahadeva Swayam Bhur Bhuta Bhavana Dhyaya Mana Prashna Bijam Nabhya Padyatta Karmadhi Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Evam Pushto Mahadeva Swayam Bhut Swayam Bhur Bhuta Bhavana Dhyaya Mana Prashna Bijam Nabhya Padyatya Karmadhi
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Evam Pushto Mahadeva
Evam Pushto Mahadeva
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavanah
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavanah
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Nabhya Padyata Kamadi
Nabhya Padyata Kamadi
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Evam Prushto Mahadeva
Swayam Bhur Bhuta Bhavana
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Nabhya Padyata Karmadi
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Evam Prushto Mahadeva
Evam Prushto Mahadeva
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavana
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavana
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Dhyayamana Prashna Bijam
Nabhya Padyata Karmadi
Nabhya Padyata Karmadi
Matajis
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Evam Prushto Mahadeva
Evam Prushto Mahadeva
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavana
Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavana
Dhyaya Mana Prashna Bijam
Dhyaya Mana Prashna Bijam
Nabhya Padyata Karmadhi
Nabhya Padyata Karmadhi
Word to word meaning Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha
The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, Evam, thus, Prushtaha, questioned, Mahadevaha, the great God Brahma, Swayambhuha, without material birth, born directly from the body of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. bhuta,
bhuta
of all conditioned souls,
of all conditioned souls.
Bhavanaha,
bhavanaha,
the creator,
the creator
of their conditioned life. Dhyayamanaha,
seriously considering
prashna
of the question,
bijam,
bijam,
the essential truth, nabhyapadyata,
did not reach
karmadhihi,
intelligence bewildered
by his own activities of creation. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, S. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, "My dear Uddhava, Brahma Himself, who is born directly from the body of the Lord and who is the creator of all living entities within the material world, being the best of the demigods, seriously contemplated the question of His sons headed by Sanaka. The intelligence of Brahma, however, was affected by his own activities of creation, and thus he could not discover the essential answer to the question." Purport. Srila Jiva Goswami has quoted three verses from the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam as follows. In the 9th chapter, verse 32, Lord Krishna blessed Brahma with the realized knowledge of the Lord's actual form, qualities and activities. In the 9th chapter, verse 37, the Lord ordered Brahma to rigidly carry out the Lord's injunctions and affirmed that Brahma would thus never be bewildered in his cosmic decision making. In the 6th chapter, verse 34, Lord Brahma assured his son Narada, "O Narada, because I have caught hold of the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Hari with great zeal, whatever I say has never proved to have been false, nor is the progress of my mind ever deterred, nor are my senses ever degraded by temporary attachment to the matter." In the present verse, in the 13th chapter of the 11th canto, Lord Krishna states that Brahma unfortunately did become bewildered by his creative functions, thus providing a grave lesson to all of the Lord's empowered representatives. Although one may be elevated to an exalted position in Lord's transcendental service at any moment, there is a danger of false pride polluting one's devotional mentality. Om Ajnanati Mirandhasya Jnananjanam Shalakaya Chakshurun Milatam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Mukam karoti vachalam pangam langayate girim yat kripatam aham vande sri gurum dinadarinam paramanandamadavam nama om vishnu padaya krishna prashtaya bhutale srimate bhakti vedanta swaminiti namine namaste saraswati deve gauravani pracharine nirvishesha shunyavadi paschatya deshatarine नीलाचल निवासाय नित्याय परमात्मने बलभद्र सुभद्राय श्री जगन्नाथाय ते नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत श्री राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये नित्यानंदमहं नौमि। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो टुडे वी विल बिगिन आवर डिस्कशन विद glorification of Uddhavaji. We will try to discuss how Uddhava was one of the most intimate friends of Lord Krishna, like Arjuna, and then gradually we will come to the verse. We already knew that Arjuna was a very, very confidential associate of the Lord. Very confidential. So much so that Krishna agreed to become his chariot driver. Once when the war between Kauravas and Pandavas were declared, both Duryodhana and Arjuna, they went to Krishna to seek some help, because Krishna was connected with both the families. And Arjuna sat at the lotus feet of the Lord, and Duryodhana, he sat near his lotus face. So when Krishna woke up from his sleep, he saw first Arjuna, and he was very surprised to see Duryodhana also there. So both of them, they said that we are here to seek some help from you for the war which is going to happen. And Krishna said, okay, you have come, but I have a condition that I won't be lifting any weapon. So how is that I will help you? So on one side I am available without any weapons, on the other side I have my Narayani Sena, all my Narayani soldiers, which can be used for any of the parties. And so Duryodhana said that, let me go first and ask. He said, no, I saw Arjuna first, and also he is your younger brother, so he should be allowed first. So Krishna, he was testing Arjuna. And Arjuna said, oh my dear Lord, what will I do with Narayani Sena? I want Narayan, I want you. If you are there with me, I only want that you should become my chariot driver. If you kindly become that, then I can even defeat Lord Shiva. I don't want any Narayani Sena. And Krishna happily agreed to become the chariot driver of Arjuna. And on the other side, Duryodhana was laughing, saying, what a foolish person he is. So the role of a chariot driver was not a big service. It was a menial service. A role of a driver is to keep the car clean, is to welcome the owner of the car, used to open the door for him. So such a small seva. So Krishna used to perform all these things. It is said in some of the commentaries of the Acharyas that whenever Arjuna used to come to board on the chariot, Krishna used to give him his hand, and Arjuna used to put his hand on Krishna's hand, and then used to climb the chariot. And also while getting down, Krishna used to first get down himself, then hold Arjuna's hand, and then he used to come down from the chariot. And sometimes during the battlefield of Kurukshetra, there are instances in the battlefield where one has to indicate to the sarathi, to the driver, to go right or go left, go straight or go back or wait. So normally it is performed with the help of the kick of the leg. They kick the chariot driver. So Arjuna used to kick Krishna. And Krishna used to tolerate that as a matter of love. For him, Krishna was, for him it was pure love of Arjuna. So Krishna used to always also clean the horses of Arjuna, the four horses which were tied to the chariot of Arjuna. Krishna's responsibility, Krishna saw that they are cleaned nicely, and if they are injured, then they are getting proper medication. So in this way, Krishna and Arjuna were very, very intimate. And Krishna, out of love for Arjuna, accepted this menial service. And also, Krishna, although he had 16,108 wives and he was supposed to be staying in Dwarka, but very often he used to come and spend time with Arjuna and Pandavas. And very less time he was spending in his own palace in Dwarka with his dear wives. So we can understand the intimate relationship of Krishna and Arjuna, and that is why Krishna said in the Bhagavad Gita, I am giving you this transcendental knowledge because you are my most dear associate. So now we have to understand that Krishna is giving this transcendental knowledge to Uddhavji. So we should let us try to understand how intimate Uddhava was with Krishna. So Uddhava is also Yadava, among the Yadava dynasty. He was a disciple of Brihaspati. He was Brihaspati Shishya. And he was very, very, very dear friend of Sri Krishna. Very dear and intimate friend. And Uddhava looked exactly like Krishna. The same complexion, the same stature, the same height, and everything was like Krishna. Except for the peacock feather, or he never used to carry flute, or he... but he was exactly looking like Krishna. Often in the assembly of Dwarka, there is to be lots of ministers, and they used to discuss with Krishna. In fact, Krishna used to take every decision discussing with his dear associates, and Uddhava was one of the valuable advisors to Krishna. Not all the Yadavas were fortunate enough to always remain with Krishna, but Uddhava was such a person who always stayed with Krishna. Wherever he went, Krishna went along with him. Other Yadavas, they never got that fortune to be with Krishna all the time. Sometimes the Lord used to send Uddhava on various kinds of missions, and Uddhava was very pleased to do that. There was a situation once when Krishna's son Samba was in love with Duryodhana's daughter, and when he went there to get hold of her, then Bhishma and Duryodhana, they captured Samba. So Krishna sent, it was supposed that Krishna could have himself gone, but Krishna sent Uddhava to rescue and console the Lord's dear devotees. And Uddhava used to felt more satisfaction when he used to go for Lord's service. He used to take a lot of pleasure that Krishna is allowing me, like we are engaged in Lord's service, Ladalandaneshwar's service. So we are very pleased. So Uddhava also was very pleased when Krishna used to instruct him, go this way, go that way, go there, go here, do these things. And Uddhava was the only one of the Yadavas who used to always stay with Krishna even during the time of his meals. So Uddhava often got the remnants of Krishna's Mahaprasad. And with great pleasure, Uddhava, he used to massage Lord's feet while sleeping, and sometimes he himself used to fall asleep while the Lord's lotus feet were on his lap. So in this way, Uddhava was very, very fortunate. And since childhood, he was absorbed in thinking of the Lord. He had a deity of Lord Krishna, and he was so mad in love with that deity that he used to always talk with that deity. And some of the people who were not aware of his constitutional position as a pure devotee, they used to say he's a madman. But Uddhava was always absorbed. Although Uddhava was a Kshatriya born in Bharatvarsha, and his color should have been something like this, but he was born with a body exactly like Krishna. And Krishna was so kind to him that he used to give him his own clothes, own garlands, and sometimes the garland were such long that it used to come to wearer's leg, such long garlands. And Krishna, sometimes he used to offer him Kaustubha jewel also, which only the associate in the Vaikuntha, only the Lord used to wear. Krishna used to offer that Kaustubha money to Uddhava. So sometimes when Uddhava used to go for Krishna's business, the devotees used to get bewildered. Sometimes they used to think that when Krishna was not in Dwarka, when Krishna was absent from the Dwarka, so they were in separation from the Lord. And then all of a sudden Uddhava used to come from some business trip, and they used to feel so amazed that, is this Krishna? And they used to say, no, this is not Krishna, this is Uddhava. But then still, by seeing Uddhava and realizing that it is their mistake, that it is not Krishna, but still they were very pleased to see him. His exceptional beauty made them remember Krishna's beauty. That was Uddhava. And Uddhava was such a confidential associate of the Lord that once Krishna sent him to Brajabhumi, because Krishna was in Mathura and gopis were in Vrindavan, and they were in separation from each other. The gopis were constantly and always thinking of Krishna, and Krishna was always thinking of the gopis. And neither gopis could come to Mathura, or neither Krishna could go to Vrindavan, but Krishna was in separation, and he knew that everybody in Vrindavan was crying and was on a verge of dying. So Krishna wanted to send a message of love to the gopis, to Nanda Baba, Mother Yashoda, and all of them. So Krishna was looking for appropriate person, and he chose Uddhava. And he sent a confidential messages from the hands of Uddhava, and he told him, please go and console my parents and gopis and everybody. So when Uddhava entered Vrindavan, all the gopis, when they saw, they were amazed, saying, is it Krishna? He looks exactly like Krishna. But then the gopis thought, no, he doesn't have a peacock feather, he doesn't have a flute, he cannot be Krishna, but he looks exactly like Krishna. And the gopis, they came to know that this is Uddhava, who has come with a message from Krishna. So this is how Uddhava was such a confidential associate of the Lord. And just like Krishna gave this transcendental knowledge to Arjuna, the transcendental knowledge of Bhagavad to Arjuna, because he was his most intimate devotee. So here, Krishna has given this transcendental knowledge to Uddhava because he is also one of his most intimate devotees. So, now Krishna, let's come to the verse. Now Krishna is having a conversation with Uddhava, and Krishna is advising Uddhava that one should be very careful, Uddhava, in controlling one's mind. Although the mind might go here and there, but try to engage your mind in thoughts of me. Try to always absorb yourself in my thoughts. This is what even Sanat Kumar, I gave this instruction to Sanat Kumar also. So when Uddhava heard, you gave this instruction to Sanat Kumar on mind, I would like to listen that in a little detail. So he asked Krishna, oh Keshava, at what time and in what form did the sages headed by Sanaka heard about this transcendental knowledge from you? And then the Lord said, there was a time when these four Kumaras, they went to Lord Brahma, and they put forward a very intelligent question to Lord Brahma. And the question was, oh my dear Lord, the sages asked Brahma, oh Lord, people's minds are naturally attracted to material sense objects. And similarly, the sense objects in the form of desire enter their mind. Naturally their mind is absorbed in the material objects. But still, if such a person who wants to be liberated, who wants to become absorbed in the thought of the Lord, what should one do? So he put forward this question to Brahmaji, the four Kumaras. And Brahma, he got bewildered. Then today's verse is that Evam Prashto Mahadeva Swayambhur Bhuta Bhavana Dhyaya Manaha Prashna Bijam Nabhya Padyata Karmadhi. So the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Brahma, the creator of the whole universe, he got bewildered of this question. It is not normal that Brahma, the Supreme Creator, he is bewildered by these questions, because he knows everything. Srila Jiva Goswami, in his commentary, he says that he has quoted three verses, and he said that Lord Krishna has blessed Brahmaji with the realized transcendental knowledge. He said that Brahmaji has realized everything about the Supreme Lord. His form, his qualities, his activities, everything. Brahma is aware of everything. But still here, we see that Brahma is bewildered. So this bewilderment of Brahmaji is not a new thing. If you see in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Brahma was bewildered also. There is a pastimes when Krishna killed Aghasur. At that time, Brahmaji, he went to see that who is this person who has killed Krishna, who has killed this Aghasur. And when Brahma went there, Krishna was doing a funny game there. Krishna, he was having food with his boyfriends, cowherd boyfriends, and Krishna, he liked one of the dishes. And some of the, when one of his coward boyfriends, he ate that dish and said, Krishna, this is very nice. And then Krishna caught hold of his neck and then he removed that bite from his mouth, and Krishna went and took it. And this is what Brahma saw. And Brahma got bewildered. He's saying, he is the Supreme Lord? No way. My Lord is not like this. He cannot eat from somebody's mouth like that. Such a dirty thing. He is not like that. So Brahma got bewildered. And Brahma thought of testing Krishna. The Supreme Brahma, Supreme Creator, the Son of God, he wanted to test Krishna. So he made an attempt to kidnap the cowherd boys and the calves. Now there is a big mystery here. Big mystery. We discussed the subject matter in Germany this year in a Bhagavat Mahotsav which was organized. And the mystery is that it is said that there are two sets of boys, but there are actually three sets of boys. Yes. I'll try to explain you in brief. So when Brahma, he was bewildered, and at that time the calves who were herding, they went deep in the forest. So it has been said that Brahma kidnapped the calves. So when he made an attempt to kidnap the calves at that time, Mahamaya, this is what Acharya says, Vishwanatha Thakur says, that the Mahamaya, it created a duplicate set of boys and duplicate set of calves, and Brahmaji kidnapped those. And the original set of boys and the original set of calves, they were under the spell of Yogmaya, and that pastimes continued. So now one set of boys and one set of calves is with Brahmaji. Second set of the original ones, the pastimes is going on. So Krishna, now, he created another set of boys and calves for giving pleasure to the gopis of, the Vatsalya gopis of Vrindavan. Because all these gopis, they always used to think that when will they get to feed milk to Krishna. So to fulfill their desire, Krishna expanded himself into so many different forms of calves and the boys, and they remained for one complete year with the gopis. And this, under the spell of Yogmaya, they continued their pastimes undisturbed for one complete year. And till that 1 year, Krishna was with the gopis as a calf, with the gopis as their cowherd boys, and with the cows as their calves. So this is how the bewilderment of Brahma. Brahma still couldn't figure out. Vishnu Chakra Thakur says that even the whole thing was over, Brahma couldn't figure out which were the original. So there are three sets of boys. So similarly, the demigods like Indra also, they get bewildered. Indra, so many years the Brajavasis, they worshipped Indra. So one occasion Krishna told them that, why are you worshipping Indra? You should worship Giri Govardhan. And Indra, he accepted this seva from the Brajavasis for so many years continuously. But for 1 year, the Brajavasis worshipped Govardhan, and Indra got offended. And he sent Samvartaka clouds to kill them, to kill their cows, to kill all of them. And he wanted to destroy Brajmandal. But Krishna protected them. So, by this we can understand the nature of the demigods and the nature of Krishna. That the nature of the demigods is that if we take shelter of these demigods and someone worships them, and if you tend to not worship them for some time, then this is how they take revenge. They kill the same, they kill their own devotees. But the Lord is not like that. We can know that Lord is Bhakta Vatsala. We can compare this understanding. We can understand what is the nature of the demigods and what is the nature of the Supreme Lord. Similarly, then Krishna chastised Brahma also for his stupidity, and then Krishna chastised Indra also and brought them back to senses. So here also, Brahma was bewildered. even though he was the supreme knower of all the absolute truth, but now Hamsa, will Lord will take incarnation as Hamsa avatar, and he will clarify and help him understand Brahma and the Sanat Kumar, and help them understand this science of Krishna consciousness. If you see, even Arjuna, he was also bewildered on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And Arjuna was very confident when the battle started, but then when he expressed a desire to see the opposite party, who was fighting with him. So Krishna said, okay, let's go. And Krishna took the chariot right in the middle. And then Arjuna saw all his associates, all his brothers and all his uncles and all his Gurujanas are all ready to fight against him. And Arjuna said, I don't want this. I just want to give up everything and take sannyas. And then Krishna chastised him. He was bewildered, Arjuna was bewildered. And Krishna said to him that, you just have to follow my instruction. And he said the entire Bhagavad Gita. And this is how Krishna helped Arjuna to understand his dharma. So in this way, we see so many incidences in Bhagavatam where the devotees get bewildered, and then Krishna or their senior associates, the sadhus, they help the devotees come out of this bewilderment. You see, Yudhishthira Maharaj, at the beginning of the war, Arjuna was not willing to fight. And now after the war was over, now Yudhishthira Maharaj was bewildered. He was saying that, I don't wish to accept this position of king. Because of me, all this war has happened, and because of me, I am responsible for this. So I don't wish to accept this kingdom. See, Yudhishthira Maharaj was Dharmaraj. He was knower of all the truths, but he was bewildered here. Krishna tried to explain him. Vedavyas tried to explain him, but he didn't accept. He said, I cannot accept the kingdom. Krishna, the Supreme Lord, who is there in the hearts of everyone, he was explaining him, and he didn't understand. And then Vedavyas, who is the author of all the Vedic scriptures, he was explaining him, and Yudhishthira Maharaj didn't understand. Dhoma Rishi explained him, so many other rishis explained him, and Yudhishthira Maharaj was convincing himself that he is not a proper candidate for becoming a king. So in this way he was bewildered. But then Krishna said, okay, you don't have faith in me, you don't have faith in Vedavyas, you don't have faith in Dhoma Rishi, you don't have faith in Kripacharya, but you have faith in Bhishma Pitama? He said, yes, I have faith in Bhishma Pitama. So then all of them, they went to Bhishma Pitama, and Bhishma Pitama helped Yudhishthira Maharaj understand the position of Krishna. So this was actually pastimes of the Lord to glorify Bhishma Pitamaha. But whenever we are also bewildered, it is important for us to take shelter of sadhus, to take shelter of senior devotees. So Brahma, who was so much elevated soul, and he came under the bewilderment that he got in such a situation. And one of the reasons Krishna gives is that he was so much engrossed in his creation responsibilities. This is what Krishna gives the reason. And because of that, he forgot about me and my transcendental knowledge. So you should imagine our situation when we are rendering so many services in management especially, then it becomes so difficult to always remember Krishna. So it is very important that in all the circumstances we should try to always remain absorbed in hearing, reading and speaking about the Lord, in taking shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is food for the soul. And unless we are not properly nourished, we won't be able to do our services properly. If somebody is engaged in doing kirtana, if he is nourished with the help of Srimad Bhagavatam, then that kirtan will suddenly take him on a different platform. He will be performing lovingly Yeah. If he has heard about, he has heard Srimad Bhagavatam. Similarly, if someone is doing a service of deity worship and he has heard Srimad Bhagavatam nicely, he has absorbed himself in Srimad Bhagavatam, then he will be able to serve the deities in a very nourished way, very, very nicely, with lots of love and affection for Krishna. So any service for that matter, we have to also absorb in Srimad Bhagavatam. Otherwise, it will be like Brahmaji. Brahmaji was so absorbed in so many services of creation, but that he forgot about this science of Krishna consciousness. So we will be in similar situation. This is a lesson for us. This pastime is for us, so that we can understand how important it is to always remain absorbed in hearing about the Lord's activities and reading about them. So important. We see in Srimad Bhagavatam that Ajamil, he saw one picture of a prostitute who was indulged in sexual activities with a man, and Ajamil had a fall down. Here we are staying in the city of London, and we go outside and we see thousands of like that. Thousands of similar situations, the similar scene which Ajamil saw. So we can imagine how degraded our consciousness can be. So it is very important that we keep ourselves nourished at all the time. If we are properly nourished at all the time, especially when we take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam, then Srimad Bhagavatam will protect us. It will help us to be always remain Krishna conscious. That's why it is said, Nashta prayeshu bhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shlokir bhaktir bhakti naishtiki. So it is said, nityam bhagavata sevaya. All that time we should be absorbed in serving Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is of, we all know that Bhagavatam is of two kinds, and we have to serve them all the time. Person Bhagavat, we serve them by following its instructions and making it as life and soul. It is very important to make their instructions as our life and soul. Srila Prabhupada, he made the instructions of his spiritual master as his life and soul. He told Srila Prabhupada's spiritual master Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, told him that go to West, take this message to the West and preach. Srila Prabhupada was a grahastha, and he was trying his best in even his grahastha ashram to somehow he could collect some money and go, but he didn't. It was not possible at that time. But Srila Prabhupada always had this thing in his mind that he want to go outside, he want to carry out the order of his spiritual master. So this is a service to Bhagavata. Srila Prabhupada is letting us, all of us also, he set an example for us. If one is convinced by the process of Krishna consciousness, then he should follow the instructions of his spiritual master by making that life and soul. And he traveled to the West at the age of 70. Yes, he was a pure devotee. Yes, he was a Mahabhagavat. But he also set an example for us. How we should make the instructions of the Bhagavatas as of our life and soul. If we do that, then we will be purified ourselves. And also will help others to come in contact with Krishna. Similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam also, in the purport to this verse, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya, Nashta Prayeshu Bhadreshu, Srila Prabhupada writes that a person can take shelter of both of them or either. But if he is in contact with any one of them also, he will be delivered. So simply by serving the spiritual master, or Srila Prabhupada is saying that, he is saying that, or take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. Hear about it, read about it, and still your life, and speak about it. So you'll be able to perfect your existence. More and more we make, more and more if we absorb ourselves in the this taking shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam, then we'll make rapid progress in Krishna consciousness. So thank you very much. If you have any questions.
Thank you very much. I wanted to just clarify one thing. You know, you said about the three different sets of calves and gopas.
Yeah.
Is Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's tika or yes. some other acharyas?
Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's tika is there. Yeah.
Thank you.
You can read that.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna, thank you so much. Thank you. I have a question different from the topic. In the beginning you mentioned story about Sambha and Lakshmana marriage. So, in the end of the chapter in Krishna book, there is like a... It is confirmed by Shukadeva Goswami that the site of Hastinapur is now known as New Delhi, and the river following through the city is called the Yamuna. Also in those days it was known as Ganges. From authorities like Jiva Goswami, it is also confirmed that the Ganges and Yamuna are the same river, following in different courses. So, but it's like two different personalities.
What is the question?
Here it is one river. So how it can be two different personalities?
So the Jiva Goswami, it has been said that Jiva Goswami is saying that. Even he says that when Maharaj Parikshit was cursed, he says that he went on the banks of Yamuna because there was a question. He was questioning why will Parikshit Maharaj be in his own kingdom if he has been cursed and then he has to quit his kingdom. Normally the sages, they go outside of their kingdom and they stay in the forest. But here, why is he going? So he said that he might have gone to Yamuna. But other acharyas, they say that, not refuting Jiva Goswami's points, but they are suggesting, okay, Jiva Goswami is suggesting that might be Yamuna might be flowing nearby at that time. But Parikshit Maharaj had very less time with him. He already has 7 days only. So he won't spend so much time walking to Yamunas, which was far away, but he could have gone to Ganga, which is nearby. So some of the acharyas, they present things like that. So in either case, Ganga and Yamuna both are very, very dear to the Lord, and one can perfect their lives by simply coming in contact with them. So both are, in one sense, they're both same, because they both are connected with Krishna. So in one sense, you can say they both are same. Any other questions?
Thank you.
You have a question or we are done? Okay. Grantharaja Srimad Bhagavatam ki Samaveta Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki Srila Prabhupada ki
Jaya.